Something pretty awesome was just revealed at EA Play. It's called Battlefield Portal. EA and Ripple Effect, which is the new name for the DICE LA studio, they just revealed their big Battlefield 2042 multiplayer experience that sits alongside Battlefield 2042 multiplayer, and my goodness, is it incredible. Essentially, we've got a bunch of remastered Battlefield content from Battlefield 1942, Bad Company 2, and Battlefield 3 all thrown into this melting pot of settings, options, and modifiers called the Battlefield Builder, all of which can be controlled by the community to change the rules of war. That's the tagline. I got invited to a behind-the-scenes event a couple of days ago. I got to see everything in action, and I got a full breakdown of pretty much everything that's available here, some gameplay, and what you can really do with Portal, going really deep. So let's go through everything together. Make sure you like the video if you're excited for Battlefield Portal, and drop any questions you have below. I'll try and answer as many as I can. First of all, let's start with the inspiration for Battlefield Portal. The team at Ripple Effect wanted to make sure that players could create their own experiences within the Battlefield franchise, and they wanted to go above and beyond anything that has really been provided before. You might remember in Battlefield 3 and Battlefield 4, on PC at least, there was a large community of third-party servers that were running all kinds of different maps, different modes, and settings. Well, Battlefield Portal does all of that, and more. And it's using a web-based platform that you can log into and access all of those settings. You can create an experience and save it. Then you launch into the game, you open Battlefield Portal, and then in the menu, bam, there's your experience, part of the game, and you can start playing it. You'll also be able to find other experiences created by other players. You can search for specific experiences using a server browser, find the most popular ones within a highlighted section of the UI, and you'll even find developer-created modes alongside community-based ones. Essentially, at this point, just to make it absolutely clear, Ripple Effect has created a fully-fledged community server environment, and it's free for any player of Battlefield 2042 to use. Any player can create experiences, any player can log on and play other created experiences. All players will get access to this as part of Battlefield 2042. All you need is an EA login to create experiences. You don't even need the game to do that, although if you want to play what you end up creating, of course you will need the game, but Ripple has created all of this as an element that will be completely free to players of Battlefield 2042. All the control, all the settings, and all the content Battlefield players have wanted for years at this point. It's all here. It's kind of incredible. Portal includes content from Battlefield 1942, Battlefield Bad Company 2, and Battlefield 3 updated to the latest version of Frostbite, plus all of the content from Battlefield 2042 that will be available in Portal as well. All the past Battlefield content has been recreated to take advantage of the current Frostbite technology, and so various issues with the games in the past, they will have been overcome. So those seven maps that we know about for Battlefield 2042, those will be in Portal, plus the following from the three other Battlefield games. You've got El Alamein and Battle of the Bulge from Battlefield 1942, then Arica Harbor and Valparaiso from Bad Company 2, and then Caspian Border and Noshar Canals from Battlefield 3. So that's six more multiplayer maps recreated in the latest version of Frostbite. And with that comes all the content from those past three games. So there's over 40 weapons from across the three games, including the M1 Garand and the Panzerschreck from 1942. Then you've got like the G3 and the M416 and even the XM8 from Bad Company 2, plus all of the 2042 weapons on top of that. Then there's over 40 different vehicles as well, those coming from the three recreated games, as well as the 2042 vehicles, and then over 30 gadgets again from the past three titles and 2042. Classic factions from the previous titles, they will be available to be able to mix and match between all of them, as well as the Battlefield 2042 specialists. So that means that the classic classes from those earlier games, they will return in Battlefield Portal. So the Assault, Engineer, Support, and Recon roles from Bad Company 2 and Battlefield 3, those will return in Battlefield Portal. And like I said, it's all mix and match, so if you wanted to play with 1942 German soldiers on Caspian Border versus Bad Company 2 soldiers, then you could do that if you wanted to. It's all part of the Battlefield Builder. This is the name that Ripple Effect is giving to the web platform where you create your experiences. You can have modifiers like 3x headshot damage, double sprint speed, and restrict only certain types of weapons to be used if you want. It's literally a mosh pit of content, and you have full control over what you want to do with it. One thing I should mention at this point is that players on PC, Xbox Series X and S, and PS5, they will be able to create and play experiences within Battlefield Portal with 128 players. So if you want to, you can create a 128 player Noshar Canals TDM experience from Battlefield 3, or you can play Valparaiso Rush with 128 players. Go for it, you can create that if you want to. For Xbox One and PS4 players, you'll still be restricted to 64 player experiences, just like the main 2042 multiplayer, but you'll still have access to all of the content within Battlefield Portal, so you can still create whatever experience you want, you're just limited to 64 players. Now, Ripple has made some subtle changes to the previous game content that will be available, but they're not massive changes, they've been done for a good reason. The examples they gave were that Valparaiso now has an option to play the map with low tide, and that takes the water level down and further out, and it reveals more play space. And this was done to accommodate the 128 player limit that you can use. But you don't have to use that 128 player limit if you don't want to. So it's there as an option. If you wanted to play an absolute hell on earth 128 players Valparaiso with the water in and a really tight play space, you can do that. Or you can put the tide out and have a bit more room. And then the Battle of the Bulge and El Alamein maps from 1942, both of those have had destruction introduced to them since the originals weren't available with destruction because, well, 1942 didn't have destruction at that point in time. As I've mentioned, all the Battlefield 2042 content will also be available in Portal as well. And that goes for the future content as part of the live service and all the seasonal updates. So that means new maps, new weapons, vehicles, specialists, gadgets, robot hamsters, you name it. All of the content will become part of Battlefield Portal as time goes on. Now, I did ask the developers in a Q&A at the end of the presentation if there was any plans to add any more remastered content from other Battlefield games into the Portal in the future. And so let's say, for example, Battlefield 2142 content, like all the guns and all the vehicles and all the mechs and stuff like that. Just throw that into the melting pot. The answer was that they weren't really telling us. They'll listen to the community and react with additions and changes, but they just reiterated that all future 2042 content would be part of the Portal. So, you know, it kind of left the door open there. And then the icing on the cake, this is a really big deal, Ripple is providing players with a logic editor for Battlefield Portal. Now, for those that don't appreciate what a big deal this is, it's absolutely massive. The logic editor is going to allow players who've got an advanced knowledge to create deeper and more granular changes to the settings of the experience. And that could just be based on things that are happening in the game. You can make stuff change. The screenshot here, it gives you an idea. So you've got like a set of rules and conditions, subroutines, loads of different things that you can use that you can change the battle with. It's advanced stuff, I've got to admit. And I know a lot of players won't quite understand what this means, and if I'm honest, I don't even understand the full potential, but server admins from past games, I know they're going to be super excited for this. And there were quite a few server admins that were invited to this event to see what was going on, and they were going mental in the chat next to the presentation, so I've got an idea of how they're feeling. They're going to be able to create those truly unique experiences for players. And don't forget, all of this is being provided as part of Battlefield 2042, but technically, confirmed by Ripple and EA, you only need an EA account to log into the web portal, and then you can start messing around with this stuff. Honestly, I think this is probably with the logic editor. This is as close as we're going to be able to get to modding in Battlefield in the year 2021. You have complete control over the content that's available. You can't add any more content to the game, but you can have complete control over everything that's there. And that's really, really exciting. And here I've got a bunch of extra information that I got from the Q&A at the end of the presentation. I'm just going to fire it off, you know, really quickly so you guys have got as much info as you can possibly get. There will be guides issued by Ripple and EA to give players a general understanding of how to use this Battlefield Builder. imagine like a sort of wiki directory, and you're kind of on the right track, at least that's what the developers said. However, as time goes on, Ripple is expecting players to learn from each other when it comes to building more advanced experiences. Then XP and progression from the Battlefield portal will be tied into Battlefield 2042. So when you play in Portal, you're playing on Valparaiso, 128 players as a recon, and you're only allowed to use a pistol, whatever. Your game time, your unlocks, your rank ups, all of that still works here. Progression is linked, and it will also be linked to Hazard Zone as well when DICE comes around to revealing what that is. You can set weapon, vehicle, and gadget limits, even class limits if you want to, within Portal. If you only want players to be able to call in quad bikes from Battlefield 3, you can do so as long as the Battlefield 3 era is present in the experience. And yes, you can call in vehicles the same way as you do in 2042, you use an in-game tablet. You cannot currently have multiple eras on the same team at the same time. You can only have era versus era combat. So you couldn't have 1942 British soldiers fighting alongside the Bad Company 2 support soldiers. You can't do that. But you can have them facing off against each other. This is something that Ripple might change in the future if players want it, but it could be confusing having different factions on the same team. It just doesn't quite work. How is all of this going to be balanced? Well, it won't be. That's kind of the point. The whole portal is a massive mosh pit of content, maps, settings, and features. Ripple is giving players of Battlefield Portal complete control here. If you want to create a throwback to Bad Company 2, and you want to run Arica Harbor on Rush in that original 12v12 scenario, leaving all the settings as standard, then you can do that. And you will have inherent balance in the mode. But if you wanted to create an imbalanced scenario, say 10 defenders versus 118 attackers, but you give the defenders like 4 times more damage on their guns, and you give the attackers 75% less damage, then you could do that as well, and you can try and create your own balance, but really, it's completely up to you if the experience is balanced or not. At the end of the day, if it's fun, people will probably play it. The logic editor will be updated over time, adding more features that players want to use based on feedback. There will be a featured game screen that will greet you when you go into the Battlefield portal. This will highlight the most popular experiences. It'll be curated by the dev team so that those experiences can be played by a lot more people. There will also be a server browser where you can look through everything and you can find something more specific. The privacy options for experiences are private, password protected, and then public. Admins of the experience will have full control over it, like being able to kick and ban specific players if they see fit. I know players of Battlefield 5 and the rent-a-server system there, they're going to absolutely love being able to kick and ban players from day one, not have the feature added months later. The minimum number of players to start an experience is 1, so you could create a 1 versus 127 player AI match if you want. Oh yeah, forgot to mention, AI is available in Portal as well, so you can create PvE experiences if you want to. The possibilities are really endless. Portal supports crossplay, same limits as Battlefield 2042, so PC, PS5, and Xbox Series X and S, they can all play together, and then the Xbox One and PS4, they can play together, but there's no cross-gen. And then all of Portal is run on EA dedicated servers, so no need for players to find third-party hosts for their experiences. Basically, Battlefield Portal sounds amazing, and I can't wait to start creating these mental modes and experiences and matches alongside just replaying some of that older content on a new version of Frostbite. I think it's going to be absolutely awesome. I can't wait to play it. I hope you guys are excited as well, and I hope you want to get your hands on it too. Thanks very much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and I'll catch you all in the next one.